Hacking someone's mobile device is a crime in most countries across the world, unless authorized by law. Yet, many spouses, government agencies, and other malicious individuals are either hacking or tapping the calls of their victim mobile device. And as your cyber commander, I am here to provide you with all the tips, techniques, and technical know-how which will enable you to either detect or protect your mobile device from a hack, a spyware, or from call tapping. The following are the tips and technical know-how to use to either determine if your mobile device is being hacked, tracked, is being spied on, or if your calls and messages are being tapped or being listened to. The first tip and technique to determine if your mobile device has been hacked or is being spied on is by deleting any unknown apps. That is, an app that you have not installed yourself but is on your mobile phone, which could be a spyware. Because spywares are generally malicious softwares, most spywares often hide itself in the app settings, instead of it displaying on a general apps icon display gallery. So in order to get rid of any spyware on your mobile device, often inspect your installed apps on your app settings in the general settings option and delete any apps that you may have not installed on your mobile device but is on display as an installed app. It's important to note that some of the apps in the app settings may be pre-installed by the phone manufacturer. So in order to be on the safer side, I recommend you to periodically format your mobile device in order to get rid of any malicious app or spyware. Since a spyware can easily be installed on your mobile device by a trusted friend, a partner, or even your spouse. Remember, your mobile phone or your tablet is the keeper of your private and your secret informations. So always safeguard it and never trust its content with anyone. The second technique in using to determine if your mobile device has been hacked, is being spied on, cloned, or if your calls has been tapped or diverted is by just dialing the following 11 MMIE supplementary service USSD codes on either your mobile phone or tablet with either a SIM card or a GSM functionality. Disclaimer: the following USSD codes and techniques are being shown for cybersecurity awareness, so must not be used to hack any mobile device or tap any calls or messages. First on our list of USSD code is *#06#. This USSD code is used in checking the unique identification number of a mobile device, which is the International Mobile Equipment Identity Code, which is often referred to as IMEI. The IMEI number of a mobile device can be used to either clone or duplicate a mobile device in order to access its calls, messages, and apps. For this reason, I advise you to always hide your IMEI number of your mobile device from third parties. Because the International Mobile Equipment Identity Code can be used to clone or duplicate a mobile device, most mobile device manufacturers are no more printing the IMEI number of mobile devices on its back case and its battery chamber as they used to. Subscribe and like the video if you would want me to make a video demonstrating how the IMEI number of a mobile phone can be used to clone and duplicate a mobile phone. It's important to note that mobile phones with multiple SIM card slots and capabilities will display multiple IMEI number depending on the number of SIM card slots of the mobile phone. For instance, a dual SIM card phone will display two different IMEI number with each representing the two SIM card slots. Also note that the IMEI number of a mobile phone can also be used to check the originality, the model, brand, and the manufacturer of a mobile phone. So it's based on your IMEI number that your internet service provider and your network carrier is able to detect and tell you the brand, the model, and the manufacturer of your mobile phone anytime you call the call center for assistance. It is important to also note that modems, routers, walkie-talkies, and mobile phones without SIM card slot all have an IMEI number. And the fact that no two different mobile phones is manufactured to have or to share the same IMEI number, unless one is cloned or duplicated using the IMEI number of the other. Remember to safeguard and keep the IMEI number of your mobile device secret, since it can be used to hack and tap your calls and messages, and as well as can be used to clone and duplicate your mobile phone, your modem, router, and your walkie-talkie. The second way through which most mobile phones are getting tracked and hacked is through call tapping and call diversion. Call diversion and call tapping are both common means through which most mobile phones and mobile lines get hacked. Call tapping is the continuous tracking and recording of both text messages and calls made or received by a mobile phone, and is often used as means to reading text messages and listening to calls of either a suspect or an adversary by most state security agencies, but is often with the permission of a judiciary authority or a court, since it is criminal and a form of invasion of a citizen's privacy in most countries. While call diversion is the act of redirecting messages and calls from one phone to another, and often requires the physical access to the victim's phone for its activation. Though a call diversion is often manually configured, it can also be remotely configured on a mobile phone. Disgruntled and jealous spouses, partners, and close friends often rely on call diversion as a means to read and listen to the calls and messages of their victim's mobile phone. Both call tapping and call diversion mobile hack activity is almost impossible to detect on a mobile phone due to their silent and secretive operational nature. The following are USSD codes used in detecting and deactivating any form of call diversion on a mobile communication line. The *#61# USSD code is used in detecting a conditional call forwarding call diversion on a mobile line. Just dialing *#61# will reveal to you if someone else answers your missed call through a call diversion. Unlike other forms of call diversions, a conditional call forwarding diverted calls always reflect on both the victim's mobile phone call log and the monthly phone bills from the victim's network service provider. So, anytime you notice an answered call in your call log that in actual fact you never answered but is registered as a received or an answered call in both your phone call log and your monthly phone bills from your cellular network service provider, then it could be that there's an active conditional call forwarding diversion on your mobile communication line. Most mobile phone spyware apps often depends on a conditional call forwarding diversion in order to send messages, call logs, and the general calls made and received by its victim to a third party, that is, to a cyber adversary. A conditional call forwarding diversion is mostly used by CADES, debit card fraudsters, to divert a bank transaction confirmation authorization code or call to their phones in order to confirm their fraudulent banking transactions under the false pretense of their victim's confirmation to their fraudulent banking transactions. So, for this reason, I urge you to always check your conditional call forwarding diversion status of your mobile communication line by dialing the *#61# USSD code on your mobile phone. The following is a countermeasure to a conditional call forwarding settings and configuration on a mobile communication line. Simply dialing *#61# will automatically erase and deactivate any form of a conditional call forwarding settings and configuration on a mobile communication line. The second USSD code for checking another form of a call diversion is *#62#. Simply dialing *#62# on your mobile phone will reveal any number that received both your calls and your messages when your mobile phone is switched off or when your mobile communication line is unavailable or is out of reach. The countermeasure to the erasing and deactivating of any configuration settings of both calls and messages diversion to a third party when a mobile communication line is either off or is out of reach is the dialing of *#62# USSD code. So to simply put, dial *#62# to check the calls and messages diversion activation status of your mobile communication line when your mobile communication line is either switched off or is out of reach. And simply dialing *#62# to deactivate any form of calls and messages diversion on your mobile communication line when your mobile communication line is either switched off or is out of reach. *#67# is the third USSD code on our list of call diversion USSD codes. Dialing *#67# on your mobile phone will uncover any number that received both your messages and your calls when your mobile communication line is either busy or on a busy mode. There are two different countermeasures to this particular form of call diversion. The first countermeasure is to activate the call waiting status on your mobile communication line in order to allow incoming calls whilst your mobile communication line is inactive with another call. while the second countermeasure is to simply dial #67# to deactivate and erase any call diversion configuration settings that divert all your calls and messages to a third-party number when your mobile communication line is busy or either in an active call or in a busy mode status. The following USSD codes are codes used in checking the active status of all the forms of call diversions there is, that is, the active status for both conditional and unconditional messages and calls diversions. The *#21# USSD code is used for the scanning of any form of call diversion configuration settings on a mobile communication line. And the *#002# USSD code is used in checking the status of both conditional and unconditional messages and call diversion configuration settings. While the *#004# USSD code is used to show both the active status and all other related informations regarding all the conditional call diversion forwarding on a mobile communication line. That is, relating to if a mobile communication line is either switched off, out of reach, busy or on the reject call option, or when the mobile communication line is on the don't reply to a call status. In a simple explanation, instead of using the *#61# USSD code or the *#62# USSD code or the *#67# USSD code for checking the individual status of all the forms of conditional forwarding call diversion configuration settings, dialing the *#004# USSD code on your mobile phone will check the status of all the forms of both calls and messages conditional forwarding call diversion configuration settings running on your mobile communication line. While the following USSD code can be used to erase and deactivate all forms of call diversions on a mobile communication line. The *#21 USSD code is used to erase and deactivate all forms of call diversion configuration settings on a mobile communication line. While the *#02# USSD code is used to deactivate both conditional and unconditional messages and call forwarding configuration settings on a mobile communication line. The *#004# USSD code is the ultimate code to erase and deactivate all active forms of conditional forwarding configuration settings running on a mobile communication line. It is important to note that some of these USSD codes may not work or may not return any valid response depending on the settings of your internet service provider, though all these USSD codes ought to work on all mobile phones and across all internet service provider and cellular networks. Also note that most call forwarding and call diversions are often configured manually on a target mobile phone. So protect your mobile phone from getting tapped by not making it easy to be accessed by both strangers and your loved ones. For both cybersecurity, cyber forensic and cyber reverse engineering tips, training and technical know-how, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit on the notification button in order to be notified anytime I upload a new video.